Pass is complete to number 88, Maddox Muttley. Tackle by number 3, Aiden Owens. There's a flag on the play.
All right, Red Devil fans, if you're with us now, we have been working diligently to try to get this live stream going for you. I'll tell you what you've missed so far. You have missed some mistakes that the Red Devils have made that have actually cost them severely. They had some big plays they gave up. Our current score is 14-7. Isaiah will be on the camera there, moving to camera for us here shortly, but Cougars are up 14-7. Red Devils have missed some opportunities to score and even this thing up. Penalties have kind of hurt us, and we've given up a couple of big plays. But we're in it now. There's 8 minutes, 21 seconds left in the half. Cougars got the ball first and 10 in Red Devil territory. Four receivers wide. Snap goes back. Deep pass to the right side. Intended for Burdine. Seward is into coverage. Pass falls incomplete. And that's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Cougars. We apologize for the delay that's been to get this thing going, but we've been struggling getting some connection here just to get the Wi-Fi going. And we want to say thank you to the NRC staff for helping us get this thing going right now. Second down and 10, four wide receivers for the Cougars. Snaps back. Ball goes up the middle to number 22, and he's met there by a bunch of Red Devils. Looks like Carson Davis was in on that. Ryan the Hammer Hedge in on that as well. McGinnis, several others. Short gain, if any at all. Going to bring up third down and long for the Cougars. The Red Devils have had opportunities, just haven't been able to capitalize. Too many mistakes have cost them. Third down, and we'll call it a long 9 for the Cougars. They go four wide again. Number 22 is in the backfield. He's given us some trouble, not only last year, but this year as well. Pass is out to Burdine. It's completed, and he's tackled out of bounds there by Auld and by Joe Fixico. A moderate gain, going to bring up fourth down. Looks like in about 5 or 6 for the Cougars. Fourth down and 5, 7:32. Hey, are you in?
I'm in. We're good to go, I think.
Hey, a big hand for Isaiah Cameron. He has done great work trying to get this thing going, and it's just been a struggle. Fourth down. And the pass is complete up the middle for a Cougar touchdown. Another opportunity to get off the field right there. We didn't get it done, but credit to the Cougars. They did a great job there of creating a matchup that they like. Their running back on a linebacker is a good matchup for them. As a clever play call. The extra point is blocked by Jackson Smith. That'll move our score to 20-7. The North Rock Creek Cougars leading with 7:26 remaining in a half.
Low frequency, can you hear that?
I can hear you, yes.
Oh, can you hear like the staticky?
A little bit.
Yeah, we're going to roll with it.
Yeah, we're just glad to be on the air.
Yeah.
I don't know that anybody's going to join us now. It's been so long, they've given up hope.
They're just driving over here to North Rock Creek.
This
now.
Is a great lesson for you, though. Never give up hope. There's always hope. Well, Isaiah, before the game started, I want to talk to you about the keys of the game.
Yes.
And the keys of the game were two. One, we got to win the game in the trenches.
Okay.
We have kind of struggled down there sometimes, but giving up big plays. I mean, that's three touchdowns that North Rock Creek has on three big plays.
Right.
And their first drive was pretty good. They matriculated the ball down the field pretty well, made a nice play to Burdine, nice pass in the corner. But that second touchdown they got, I know you didn't see it. You were working with the computer. But
right.
The second touchdown was a 70-yard run. We had the guy tackled in the backfield, or at least for no gain, by two or three defenders had him and let him loose, and he runs 70 yards for a touchdown. We got a tackle down all the way to the ground, and then we got to play defense on the back end as well. So big plays are kind of haunting the Devils right now, but they got a chance to go score and narrow this lead right before the half.
And to whoever is keeping the score updated for us, a big thank you for that.
Yes, sir. Kick is going to be fielded by, looks like, Jayon Friend. Shakes loose one defender, and he's tackled down at about the 25-yard line. Red Devils take over first down and 10, right at the 25-yard line. Red Devils been going back and forth with their quarterback combo. And it's been good for him. At times, Ault's very shifty.
Yes.
And he does a good job of getting us some good looks in the run game. And Geyser has thrown some good balls tonight, and so they do make a good little mix-up. It looks like
if Brooks was here, he would express that we use him like a government mule.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Like a government mule. Looks like Geyser wrecks the Rifleman. Geyser's back in at quarterback. We've got two wide. Ball's going to go to McGinnis over the left side. He's got a little bit of running room. And he's tackled down there by a host of Cougars. McGinnis has been running hard. Very reminiscent of his brothers.
Yes.
I don't know that he's quite as big yet. He's just a junior.
Right.
And he'll have a whole nother year to kind of get some more size on him, but he runs hard with a lot of heart.
Yes, and Mandy feeds them boys well.
She does. She must be a good cook.
Yeah.
Second down and 5 for the Red Devils. McGinnis in the backfield again with Geyser. Two wide. Geyser's back to pass. He's looking at the right side. He's got a receiver. And looks like the pass is broken up. Intended for Fixico.
Kind of like not throwing a flag there, let him play a little bit.
Yes, sir. Well, pretty good timing by that safety.
Right. Yeah.
And Geyser's kind of taking a risk there, trying to get that in there before the safety gets there.
Right.
And he almost got it done. But overall, good defensive play. Third down and 5 for the Red Devils.
Got about 6 minutes and 30 seconds left here.
Yep.
We got in trouble for not letting that be known last week.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, it's too hard to control on here, so we just kind of...
Yeah, I understand. You need about 8 hands to do this job.
Or 9.
Third down and 5 for the Red Devils. Guys in the backfield with McGinnis, too wide. Ball goes McGinnis up the middle. He's got a little running room. He's chopped down there by number 22. At number 22 from North Rock Creek, I don't know his name. I think his last name's Hopper. We don't have a roster up here for them. But he gave us fits last year, too. I think he scored all their points in our game last year, and then he has scored twice here today.
I think you're right by that, too.
He's a ball player.
Yeah.
And the Red Devils are going to have a decision to make there deep in their own territory. It's going to be fourth down and just inches.
I'm glad to see McGinnis out here tonight. They didn't really play him until the fourth quarter last week on offense.
Yeah. Craig's going to take a timeout. 5:48 remaining in the half. Craig has the ball fourth down in inches here. They really need to convert right here if they're going to go for it. They need to convert. They need to go get a score right here before the half and kind of narrow that margin just a little bit so that give us a little confidence coming out of the half.
Yeah, confidence more than anything.
Yeah, and I don't know. I'm glad to see McGinnis carrying the ball as well because the kid can carry the rock.
Yeah.
He's very gritty. Just like his brothers were, and I'm glad to see him carrying the ball. I know we've had a lot of sickness this week. I've already seen a few boys go to the sidelines. I saw that somebody lost their lunch, their pregame meal out there on the extra point a while ago. It's always good to see. And that reminds me to tell you to try the local concession stand next time you're in town, right? Yeah. Some of these kids have been suffering with some sicknesses. I didn't hear that until today, and they've been kind of dealing with it all week. And, you know, they might be better today, but that kind of affects you going into the game because weak.
Yes.
You haven't eaten much all week, and you're struggling with your strength and endurance. But we'll see. Looks like they're going to bring out the sticks and measure this. It'd be a lot cooler if it was already a first down.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry about that, Isaiah.
No, you're good. You are good. See here.
Taking a long time on this measurement. There's a drum roll. Looks like it's going to be a little short. Looks like about 8 inches short. So the Red Devils got a decision to make here. Certainly don't want to give the ball back to the Cougars in this territory, this deep territory here, but looks like we're going to go for it. I'm anticipating a hard count right here. There you go. That helped right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it was the phone sitting beside it.
The phone was giving us some static. All right, fourth down and inches. You got guys in the backfield with McGinnis. We'll whistle the play. Ball goes to Grant McGinnis up the middle. He's driving those legs. It looks like he's going to have enough for the first down, according to this line judge right here. And that's why you don't skip leg day right there. That way you can drive that pile forward, man. And that's good for a Red Devil first down.
Can't have them Paul Darren chicken legs.
I'm not going to make fun of anybody's legs. Anybody that's seen mine. And Geiser's going to remain in at quarterback for the Devils. McGinnis remains in the backfield. We had a that's no good. Geiser was going to try to go back to pass, and it's just a jailbreak. He swallowed up by about three Cougars right there for a loss on that play, and that's going to bring up second down, and looks like about 14 or 15 for the Red Devils. Geiser never had a chance.
Mm-mm.
Looked like something went wrong there. I don't
know. Yeah, something collapsed up there.
Second down and about 14 for the Red Devils. Geiser, the quarterback. McGinnis in the backfield. We got four wide receivers. Get that ball out. There you go. Pass is completed to Robbie Schiltz. He's hammered down pretty quickly there by a defender, but a nice pickup, nice concentration. That's what hurt us in the first quarter. I know you were busy working with the computer, but we had two big-time drop passes that really hurt us in that first period of play. One of them was a walk-in touchdown, and a different complexion on this game if we catch the ball. So that was a nice catch and way to hang on to that after getting hit like that. That's going to bring up third down and about five or six for the Red Devils. Four wide receivers. Snaps back to Geiser. Geiser's got one across the middle. Got Jayon Friend. There you go. Nice catch. Makes a nice move. Oh, a nice move. Made a guy miss. Left him laying there on his face. And that's good enough for another Red Devil first down and 10 as they move the ball across midfield. This is going to be huge right here, Isaiah, because they need to go score right now.
Yeah, we got a little under 4 minutes here, so.
Yeah, they got plenty of time.
Yes.
Three and a half minutes. They can go score. We still have two timeouts, I think, or one. My eyes are not very good. Snap goes to Geiser. McGinnis up the middle, breaking tackles, running hard, bouncing off people, and moving straight ahead. Inviting the contact. Nice run by McGinnis. What a stud. Call him Little Mac or Mini Mac.
I like that.
He's the baby McGinnis.
Yeah.
So I thought maybe call him Mini Mac.
I like that.
But I don't know. I just he's stronger than me, so I don't think I want to make him mad. I don't know if Mini Mac would make him upset or not, but that's good for a first devil, a first down for the Red Devils. I try not to make fun of people who could hurt me. First and 10, four receivers wide. McGinnis still in the backfield. Snap goes back to Geiser. Geiser's got a man. It's Robbie Schultz again. Catches the ball. He's tackled down. This is all you got to do is move the ball down the field. It's just that simple. Hey, listen, if the defense is going to back up and give you 5, 6, 7 yards at a time, take them. We got plenty of time. I'd take that all day. And that's going to give us a very manageable second down in about 4. And you do that all day, you keep moving the ball and make Geiser look like a champion. We got 4 wide, McGinnis in the backfield again. Ball goes McGinnis up the middle, running hard over the right side. Those boys are tackling him, but they're having to pay the price. Yeah. There's a toll. There's a toll to be paid.
Yeah, they're bracing for impact every time.
And that's good for a Red Devil first down and 10. Yet again, Grant McGinnis on the ground grinding it out. I call him Grant the Grinder McGinnis. How about that?
Might take that one a little better.
Yeah, Mini Mac, probably, he probably doesn't appreciate that one. 4 receivers wide. Geiser takes the snap, looking down the field. He's going to run up the middle himself, protect the ball. And he's slung down after, looked like no gain, really.
No, maybe a couple yards at most.
Yeah, he got a few yards. That's going to bring up the down marker guy is struggling. It's his fourth down, but it's only second down. If you can see that across there on the camera, ignore that. It's been like that all night. I don't know if he knows the difference between second and fourth down, but it is second down. Swing pass out to McGinnis. McGinnis gives a stiff arm, gets away from their defender, and looks like he might have an – got a little extracurricular on the sidelines there. Nobody seems to care. The ref isn't bothered by the late hit out of bounds. That's okay. If anybody can take it, it's Grant McGinnis. Nice gain on the play. Great stiff arm, by the way. And that's good for a Red Devil first down. This is what we need right here. Just go right here to score. We've got a minute left. And run up, bleed this clock out. Mm-hmm. Go to the half and get some things figured out. Got a stoppage in play here for a second here. Trying to see what the discussion is about. Having a little mound conference here. Going back to Rex Geiser. That kid found the weight room over the summer.
Oh, yeah.
I seen him at church in his street clothes, and the boy has gotten big. And he's gotten a little bit faster. And that's good, though. You need your quarterback to be pretty sturdy.
He got on that McGinnis diet.
Yes, he did. He must have been going to McGinnis' house for dinner. Yeah. He's been hitting that weight room and working hard, and it shows he's been playing well, playing tough, throwing good balls. And this it's great to have another quarterback because it gives Aiden all the chance to rest a little bit with, you know, his shoulders kind of banged up a little bit. And Aiden is so valuable on defense. Just a hard hitter, great tackler, good pass coverage.
Yeah, I thought he had got that fixed up over the summer, but.
Yeah, well, he did, but, you know, he just come right back out here and you start banging that thing again, and it messes it up again. You can just tell it's a little tender for him. Didn't hurt him last week. He had 3 interceptions last week.
Yeah, I don't think he minded it at all.
He had a hat trick last week. Yeah. I was so impressed. That kid from Meeker went home and had nightmares about Aiden all picking off his passes. All right, we got first down. It's like first and goal. The guys are in at quarterback. McGinnis in the backfield. We got 3 receivers left, 1 right. Snaps back. Ball goes to McGinnis around the left side. Makes a nice little cut. Makes a guy miss. Driving his legs towards the goal line. And he's going to be a little short. I mean, just barely. And that's going to bring up second down and goal from from the 1 yard line, less than the 1 yard line. I'd just go ahead and hand it to him one more time.
Oh, yeah.
Let everybody know. I'd just go ahead and tell them. We're going to hand it to the grinder. There's a timeout taken by North Rock Creek. There's 35 seconds remaining in the half. The Cougars are leading 20-7 over the Red Devils. Red Devils are on the doorstep, though, threatening to score right here. And if they can get this done, then that'll close the gap for us going into the half. Again, we want to apologize for the delay getting the broadcast going. It was a struggle, and we had to call in the North Rock Creek staffers to help us get this thing rolling, and we sure appreciate their help.
Yeah, the staffers over here, they were great, and then the had to get on the phone with the Squirtle guy himself.
Oh, is that who that was?
Yes, that's who was on the phone.
Okay, and he remoted in and got us going.
Yeah.
Okay, we kept dropping signal for those of you who were on with us, and we just dropped it and picked it back up and dropped it. We were doing our best to get this thing rolling, and we're sorry you missed so much of the action, but we're here now. It's Friday night. The weather's cooling off. The Devils are starting to figure it out. Got the ball rolling. This has been a nice drive for them. They needed this for their confidence moving forward. And here we go. They're lining up second down and goal from less than the 1 yard line. 35 seconds remaining in the half. Guys are in at quarterback. McGinnis in the backfield with him. Two receivers wide. It's like double tights on the right side. Here we go. Pass a handoff to McGinnis.
Oh,
right up
to
go. Just walks right in for a touchdown. Red Devil touchdown. 32 seconds remaining in the half, and that's going to move us to 20-13. And that's going to bring on everybody's favorite kicker, Robbie Shields. I don't know what Robbie's doing right here. He's stretching his hip out every time. Have you ever seen him do this when he does his extra
points? I think
points?
I've been messing with the computer every time.
If you can watch him stretch his hip out right here.
Okay.
Every time he does that, my hip feels like it wants to break. Watch him. He's going to do it. Oh, there it is right there.
I think I'd fold in half.
That's his signature move right there. But you know what he does? He kicks the ball right through the uprights every time. He's so consistent, so valuable.
Yes. Yeah.
And in high school football, class 2A football, if you got a kicker,
oh yeah,
even in any class, if you got a kicker you can rely on, they are so important, especially as you get later in the season. We're going to go into district play. Games are going to get tougher, and every point counts. And these guys these teams that have kickers who can put consistently one on after your touchdowns and put on threes if you need them, Robbie can do that.
Right. Yeah, I remember when I was in school, we did not have a kicker all 4 years, and it was going for two, and everybody knew it.
Yep, that's kind of how it was for us. We had Ron Reno when I was a sophomore. Ron Reno could kick it out of the stadium, but after he graduated from there, it was just a roll of the dice to kick an extra point. And I just thought, there's no way this should be this hard.
Right.
Now, I contend that a high school team ought to go find a kid if he isn't going to play much and just make him the kicker.
Mm-hmm.
Just say, listen, if you're not going to be on the field much, this is going to be your job. It'll be valuable to us down the road. Make him your kicker and just let him do that.
Yeah, and I mean, in the NFL, a kicking job is probably one of the best jobs in the nation.
Shoot, yeah. A lot of pressure. Now we got Schiltz getting ready to kick off for the Devils. Going south to north. The kick is away. It's a squib kick right down the middle, fielded by North Rock Creek. He's making moves on the left side. He bounces off of one tackler, and he's pushed out of bounds there. Looks like Schiltz was in on it along with a few other Devils. I think that might be the blue-collar bandit. Number 21. And that kid's a mess right there.
I'm going to have to start using that nickname. I like that.
The blue-collar bandit.
Yeah.
That's what my son Eli Raines calls him. Yeah, that's his buddy. It's his duck hunting buddy.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he calls him, the blue-collar bandit, because he's just kind of an old redneck, blue-collared guy, but he's ornery and mean. Snap is back, pass is away intended for Burdine, and it's caught, and he's tackled down there by number 13, Jackson Seward. But it's good for a nice game for the Cougars. Looks like it's going to be good enough for a first down. Maybe the chains are trying to move. Maybe there's a little confusion. Chains are not supposed to move until the referee gives them, the line judge gives them the signal. Sometimes they get excited, though. Oh, that looked like a false start right there. It's a pass deep. Intended for Burdine, get turned around. And it's going to fall incomplete. Seward was in coverage along with Auld. And Burdine is looking for a flag for the pass interference. Probably had a case to argue there, but
yeah,
it looked like there was a false start right here. It looked like this slot receiver took off early.
I was looking at the computer.
It looked like he took off a little early. No flag on the play, though. It's going to bring up second down and 10. We're at the 50-yard line. 10 seconds remaining in the half. The Cougars have the ball going south at the midfield stripe. And they're trying to get a quick score right here before the half as well. They got four receivers wide. Snap is back. Pass to the left. Falls incomplete. Braden Pickard, number six. We call him Pick Six since he's Pickard and he's number six. I have to give Eli credit for that one, too. He came up with that nickname.
We need to get Eli up here.
And no doubt. Eli's, yeah, except for he talks really slow. The broadcast would be long over before he was done talking.
Especially with me and him up here, it might go all night.
Yeah, you'd go from having Brooks, who's an auctioneer, to having Eli. So just get Eli up here to give us nicknames. All right, North Rock Creek's got the ball third down and 10, four receivers wide. Looked like another false start, but nobody seems to care. Oh, the pass is incomplete.
McGinnis was back there on him.
McGinnis is getting pressure on him. I thought he might knock that ball loose for a second.
Yeah, it looked like it.
Been a lot cooler if he did. 1 second remaining in the half. So the Cougars are going to have one last shot at it. It's fourth down and 10, ball at the 50. 1 second remaining. Cougars are leading 20-14 over the Red Devils. Cougars break the huddle. They go four wide. Devils are backed up. Snaps back. Quarterback's looking left. He gets hit in the mouth. Releases the ball, and it's going to fall harmlessly to the turf. And that's going to bring us to the end of the first half of play, with the North Rock Creek Cougars leading the Devils 20-14. And we're just glad to be here in action with you guys.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like our commercials are on here, so y'all are going to get to watch if they do any cheering or band stuff. You're going to get to catch it all.
20 minutes of pure live entertainment. People who worked tirelessly to bring you this entertainment.
Stop the flow, but whenever I try, I make it not to show up. To the whole night, it'll come trouble. The pride is under the direction of Harry Morrow and Nicole Cooper. The band is led on the field by drum major.
Not a running back.
Andre Provosny. The 2023 show is called the Red Devil Jukebox. Tonight they will be playing the first two selections, Under Pressure and Low Rider.
Thank you.
Cougar Marching Band. This season, they're under the direction of Ron Potter, Poppy Lee the drum, and Christy Potter, and led on the field by junior drum major Sawyer Sudeville. Tonight, we hope you'll enjoy the first two movements of this year's competitive show, The Haunted Music Box.
Yeah.
Hey, 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 hey.
dollar coming your way. Last three numbers on your ticket, 636. I'll give them all now. 0305 6636. Look at your tickets, please. 6636. $227 in cold hard cash. Another ticket? All right. You ever bought that ticket?
No, I don't.
Lose, lose.
I didn't get involved in the school much.
The next ticket is...
Yeah,
wait.
I'm not involved in anything, so...
We have a winner. By the hair of your kitty, kitty, kitty.
I don't know who that was.
He's the winner, $227.
They may do a magnificent job. People look like him. Looking guys that know what they're doing. And those guys put, you know, that's part of like their school.
Thank you.
All right, welcome back, Red Devil fans, for the second half of action. As we move into the second half of this great game, this non-district matchup between the North Rock Creek Cougars and the Red Devils of Prague, we come back with a six-point deficit. The Devils are behind, Isaiah, but it doesn't feel like they've been out of this game necessarily. They just have kind of hampered themselves a few times. The good news is they got a score right before half. And now they get the ball to start the second half.
And going into halftime, it seemed like a lot of that might have been worked out.
Yes. Yeah. Seemed like a lot of those issues worked out. We got to make sure that we got our defense covered on the back end. We did a little better there because it looked like North Rock Creek was going to threaten to score there again right before half, but they managed to shut that down, get a little pressure on their quarterback. We need to make him uncomfortable. The Red Devils are going to receive back deep. Is number six, Braden Pickard. And looks like number 14. I don't have a roster. That young man's name escapes me right now. I know he's a sophomore. Good little ball player. There's a kick going north to south. It's taken by Fixico. Joe Fixico takes the ball to the left side. Looks for a block. Nice block by Pickard. Cuts it back, reverses the field. Got Jayon Friend out in front, blocking. Come on, get around the corner there. And looks like he's going to be bottled up and tackled down around the 41-yard line. That's where the Red Devils will take over first down and 10.
Tackle was made by number 18.
Thought he might get something going there.
I know it. I got a little excited.
We got a cougar down on the field. Looks like a cramp. They're going to get that worked out.
I think I keep breathing into the mic, and I look around like it's thunder.
He's scaring himself. Yeah, it looks like we're going to have an official's timeout as they deal with the Cougar who's down on the 40-yard line suffering with cramps. It's still that time of year. This humid weather really takes a toll on these kids. He's up on his feet hobbling off, and that's always good to see. Just got a little cramp issue there. He'll get it worked out and be back.
The way he's acting, it looks a little more serious.
I was going to say, it looks like he's having a few more issues than just a cramp there. Hopefully he gets that worked out. Hope that young man is okay. That's the thing about football. It's dangerous. You don't want to see anybody get hurt, but it is part of the game. All right, Red Devils take over first and 10, 41-yard line. Guys are in at quarterback. Can't see who's in the backfield. I'm assuming it's McGinnis over there. Two receivers wide. Snaps back. McGinnis gets the ball over left side. Oh, gets dragged down from behind. Looked like a loss on the play. Yeah, loss of about 2 yards. Defender just coming like a rocket off that backside there. Looked like it was blocked well on this side, though.
Yeah, I'd kind of looked down right when the play took off.
Second down and 12 for the Red Devils. McGinnis remains in at running back. Two receivers wide again. Fixico right, and looks like Schilt's left. And we have a flag on the play.
False start.
False start against the Red Devils. I must have missed that one.
Yeah.
Didn't look like we even really got set for play yet.
I think the center had just picked up the ball. I don't know.
Well, the ref didn't agree with it, and so that's going to cost the Devils 5 yards and put them behind the sticks. Second down and about 16-17 for the Red Devils, 11:06 in the third quarter. Devils trailing 14-20. Two receivers right, one left. Three receivers right, one left. McGinnis in the backfield with Geyser. Snap is back. Geyser rolls right, looking for a receiver. There he is. Get it to him. And it was intended for Pickard. It falls incomplete. Looks like we had a chance for one right there. Just kind of got away from us. Tough catch, but going to bring up third down and about 17 for the Red Devils. This is not really our strong suit. Third and long is not our strong suit. No. We are historically a running game kind of a team, and so getting behind the sticks like this, penalties will kill you every time, Isaiah. Got to clean those up. Third down is 17. Three receivers right, one left. McGinnis in the backfield again. Snap goes back to Geyser. He's looking left, rolling left. Got a pass across the middle. It's completed to Robbie Schiltz. Schiltz is trying to get away from the defender. Dragged down right at the sticks. He's going to be just a touch short, don't you think, Isaiah?
I don't know.
He's standing right on the 50. It looks like that sticks at about the 49 of the Cougars. Looks like they're going to be about a yard short.
Looks short from here.
And that's going to bring up fourth down and decision-making time.
They said, oh yeah, Matt Rain's not a very third and long historically.
They're proving me wrong.
They are. They are.
And it didn't matter because there was a flag on the play.
They come in late.
I think maybe we had hiked the ball and our receiver wasn't set. Maybe the flag came out on our sidelines over there.
Okay.
Coach seems pretty upset about it.
It'd been sitting over there a while.
Yeah, I guess he threw it right. He just kind of dropped it right there on the sidelines.
Okay.
But that backs us up again. They'll get a chance to prove me wrong here. This is going to bring up third down and about 22. Four receivers wide, two right, two left.
Help if I could get the camera on the play, probably.
Snap is back to Geyser. He drops back looking for, he's got a receiver right there. If he can get loose and throw it, he gets it off. It's completed to, looks like, ball
man.
Came loose. Fumbled it forward. That was, I think it was Jayon Friend on the reception trying to make a play out there on the sideline, and the ball gets kind of punched out there.
Number 12, C.J. Stevens, brings up fourth down.
And that brings up fourth down, and looks like about seven for us. And it looks like the Red Devils are going to opt to go ahead and punt. Pickard is back deep to punt for us. And back to receive is number 22 for North Rock Creek, and this guy is dangerous. Also back there with him is Birdeye, number one. Both of those guys are extremely dangerous in the open. Uh-oh,
oh,
we got a high snap. Pickard goes back to pick the ball up, and he's going to run with it, and he's going to get nowhere. He gets swallowed up. And that's going to give the Cougars the ball at nearly the 20-yard line, the 22-yard line. That stuff will kill you right there, Isaiah. Close games like this, you just can't have those mistakes. And Pickard did his best to get back here and pick it up, but it's a hard job. I'll give some credit to the long snappers. That is a very hard job. We've got another Cougar down on the field. Looks like he might be suffering from cramps as well.
We would like to thank our chain gang tonight.
They did not get their pickle juice in.
No pickle juice.
Corky Curtis, Stephen Kingham.
So we got a little time on our hands. Where are you at on the pickle juice? Are you in or are you out on the pickle juice?
Frozen.
Frozen pickle
gotta
juice.
Got to be frozen.
Okay. I'll take pickle juice anyway I can get it. I think it's delicious. We used to serve it to football players all the time. They wouldn't hardly ever drink it. And I said, guys, not only is it going to help you, but I think it tastes good. But I like pickles. I was telling Isaiah that I always have a pickle during the games. But when you're doing the announcing, you can turn your microphone off and chomp on a pickle for a while. Can't do that here. First down and 10 for the Cougars.
I don't know if they'd mind hearing you crunch.
We'll find out. Quarterback's back to pass, fakes it, drops it deep to the corner. Looks like it could be. Oh,
man.
He was well out of the reach of the Cougars, and it looked like Auld might be in position to get his first interception of the night. He had three last week and an impressive hat trick against Meeker. And he was in position, but the ball just sailed too far out of bounds. There was a flag on the play. And they're marking it off. It went against the Cougars. Did you ever see what the call was there?
No, I did not.
I didn't see it either, but it's going to bring up first down and 20, what it probably holding, I'm assuming, 10-yard penalty. They got two receivers right, two guys in the backfield with the quarterback, and they
got him on that one.
Flag on the play. There's a flag on the play. And did the Cougars move first? There we go. False start against North Rock Creek. That'll back him up five more yards. We needed this.
Yeah. I didn't quite see that, but I'm glad they did.
And that's going to move us to first down and 25.
Still got about 10 minutes left here in the third.
Cougars break the huddle. Two receivers right, and two in the backfield with the quarterback. He takes the snap, and it's a busted play. Man. And Jackson Smith is in first, looks like, along with big number 52, Matt the Manchild Burris, in on the tackle as well. I'm sure glad it's not my job to block that kid.
Oh, man. No, me neither.
Whataburger has really helped that kid in the offseason. He eats there every day, gets the big triple stack burger. I imagine it makes him hard to block. That was a busted play as the quarterback went the wrong direction there, or somebody went the wrong direction, and resulted in another loss. Brings up second down, 27 for the Cougars. They got four receivers wide. Here comes a snap, pass to the left. And it's picked off. It's picked off. And he's running loose right down the sidelines. And guess who it is? It's pick six Pickard is who it is. And he is slammed down there. Inside, deep inside Cougar territory. The ball hit the Cougar receiver right in the chest, bounced loose, was tipped by another player, and pick six, Pickard grabbed it and took it down the sidelines. He's going to put the ball deep in the Cougar territory. Looks like they're going to have the ball at about the 23-yard line. I thought he was going to take it all the way down.
Oh, me too. I thought he was gone.
I don't know who the Cougar was that hit him on the sidelines, but he introduced himself.
Yeah.
Mr. Pickard will know who he is. Great play, great heads-up play there by Braden Pickard. That kid is just an all-around stud, just a stud. We got Auld back in at quarterback with McGinnis in the backfield, two receivers wide. First and 10. And there's a whistle to stop play. We got a timeout taken by the Cougars with 9:07 remaining in the third period.
I think after it bounced off the receiver there, he bobbled it around for a couple minutes there.
Yeah, and then all of a sudden he just took off. Yeah. I thought, well, he must have it.
Yeah, I thought it would for sure fell on the ground.
It's on the far sideline, so it gets kind of hard to see over there, but old Pickard took it the other direction. I tell you what, Braden Pickard is one of my favorite players.
Oh, yeah, me too.
I love him. Yeah. He's gritty. I mean, I don't know what he weighs. I don't have my roster in front of me. He can't weigh more than 150 pounds.
No.
But pound for pound, the kid's got to be one of the best players on the field week in and week out. He's gritty. He's fast. He has a nose for the ball. He's always in the right place.
Mm-hmm.
And just love watching him play. He plays with a lot of heart. He's got good hands, too. The Devils got a chance right here to go knock this thing up, even take a lead. We got the ball at the 23-yard line, first and 10. Aiden Auld back in at quarterback with McGinnis in the backfield. Two receivers wide. McGinnis gets the ball up the middle. And he's met immediately by Cougar defenders. Still running hard, though. Appreciate the effort. I don't know that he gained anything, maybe a yard. Bring up second down and long for y'all. Second down and 9 for the Red Devils. 8:49 remaining in the third period. Red Devils need to score right here, Isaiah.
Yeah, they need one bad.
Put the pressure on the Cougars a little bit. It's their home. They've had the lead. They've had the momentum most of the game. Yeah. Go get the lead right here. Get it up 21-20 and put the pressure on them. Ronan Martin checks in at running back in the backfield with all three receivers left. Here comes the snap. Ault takes the ball over the left side. Got blockers. Makes a nice cut. And he's met down there by several Cougars. Does gain a few yards. Gets it inside the 20 to about the 17-yard line. And that's going to bring up third down and about four. Third down and five, looks like. Says four on the scoreboard, but it says five over there at the where the marker is. But, you know, you're in four down territory right here. You can get two plays, get this done.
Oh, yeah.
Ault takes a snap, heads left, goes up the middle, makes a nice cut, makes a nice run up the middle, nice gritty run up to about the 11-yard line. And that's going to be good enough, I think, for a Red Devil first down. Am I right about that, Isaiah?
It looks like it from up. Oh,
yep, yeah.
They're
goes
picking
the
them up.
Yep. All right, first down.
They're kind of making me nervous there for a second.
They didn't want to move, did they?
No.
We have an unmotivated chain crew on the other side. We got first down and 10. At the 11-yard line, the Red Devils are knocking on the door. Chance to take the lead if they can go score right here. 7:22 remaining in the third period. Ronan Martin remains in at running back. Three receivers left. Here comes a snap. Ault takes the ball. Goes over the left side, right between the tackles. Okay, you got to give old Aiden Ault some credit. You know, the guy, he doesn't weigh very much. He's really more of a kind of an outside runner. Typically, he's very quick on his feet. Got good speed to get to the corner, but he is not afraid to stick his nose up in there between those tackles and go get hard yards. He got 2 yards on that. That brings up second down and 8 at the 9-yard line. Ronan Martin remains in at running back. No sign of McGinnis. Here comes the snap. Ball's given to Martin over the left side, and he's cut down pretty quickly at about the 8-yard line. Maybe a yard, maybe no gain. Well, it's going to bring up third down and 7 is what they're saying on the scoreboard. Still, you either got a chance to go two plays here, 4-down territory, or you got a good field goal kicker. You might go get points right here. Help your team's momentum. I noticed they brought Grant the Grinder McGinnis back in the backfield. I'd probably just go ahead and hand him the rock a couple times. Here comes a snap. They fake it to him. All rolls right. Comes back to the left. He's being chased.
Oh,
he's tackled down. The ball comes loose. And are they going to say he was down? No. The head official is saying he was down. The line judge is trying to give them the ball. North Rock Creek is arguing for the ball, but the guy in the white hat, he's the guy that makes the decisions.
Yep.
And he's saying that all was down, and I happen to agree with him. And not just because I'm on the Prague website here, but because it looked like his knee was down, and he was clearly going down when the ball popped out.
Timeout.
And a timeout is taken by the Red Devils here. 5 minutes, 49 seconds remaining in the third period. And Prague's kind of up against it right here, Isaiah. What do you do, Isaiah? You're the coach. You're the head coach. What are you going to do right here? It's 4th and 14. You're going to kick a field goal, or you're going to try to get one?
I think with the kicker that we got, I think you can just go ahead and get the points on the board. I mean, we still got a whole other quarter to play.
Right. I wouldn't disagree with that. I have all the confidence in the world that Robbie can kick it through from right there.
Yeah. No,
if we
I
can
agree.
Protect him, get the snap back, get the ball down, get the kick away, Robbie can put it through. Yeah. But I'm going to venture a guess that they're going to try to go for a touchdown here, rather than going for the 3 points, but we'll see what they're going to do. That last play just kind of broke down before it ever got off the ground.
Yeah, no.
He tried to roll right, had pressure in his face immediately, tried to go back left. Pursuit was coming, and it just didn't work out. And it looks like they're going to bring in Rex the Rifleman Geyser in at quarterback, along with Grant the Grinder McGinnis in the backfield. Got three receivers right. Schiltz is one of those. Pickard's another. They got Fixico to the left, maybe trying to get some one-on-one coverage with Fixico. Of course, Fixico's matched up against 22. We'll see how it goes here. Geyser's in the backfield. Here comes the snap. He drops back looking for a receiver. He's got Fixico. Nope. He launches one to the corner, and it's caught.
Man.
It's caught. Touchdown. Touchdown, Red Devils. Wow. Wow. What a. Are you kidding me right now? Did you not think that was going to be intercepted?
No, 100%. 100%.
That is incredible. I mean, what a gutsy pass. And what a great grab. Who even made that catch? Was that Robbie Schilt?
I don't know.
I couldn't even see who made it.
It was so congested over there, I don't even know what happened.
Well, Schilt is on for the point after right now. He's going to do his famous hip swagger here. There we go. There it is. Got to get some things loosened up. Snap is back. Ball is down. Kick is blocked. And that's going to leave our score tied 20-20 with 5:41 remaining in the third period of play. Wow, what a play. Are you trying to rewind that and see who caught that pass?
No, I'm trying to put some points on the board.
Oh, you're going to try to update the score?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good because the score is not 20-7 if you're seeing that. The score is 20-20. There's 5:41 remaining in the third period of play.
Oh, man.
And he messed it up. Now it says Prague's ahead 26-20. Don't pay any attention to that.
All right, there we go. I think me and whoever is helping me out with the score did it at the same time.
Oh, okay.
So.
I don't know who caught that ball in the corner. I know that Schilt was wide right, and so was Pickard. And I know Fixico was left. But he threw that ball into the air over there. I want to think it was Robbie Schilt. Somebody can correct me. Send me a text and kick. Kicks away. Nice kick by Robbie Schilt. What a weapon. All right, ball rolls down to the one. It's picked up there. He takes the ball to the left side of the field, trying to get across the field. And he's met down there by a bunch of tacklers. And he's tackled down at about the 13-yard line. So the Cougars are going to start first and 10 at the 13. They got a lot of work to do. That touchdown was huge. That was 4th and 14.
Yeah.
4th and 14. What a clutch play. Yeah. Rex the Rifleman Geyser. Just throwing one in there. And here's what kills me about that is we catch that, and we've dropped two or three that hit us right in the hands.
I know.
And it's just hard to watch that. And I know that those things happen, but we drop some easy ones, catch some hard ones, and that's good, though. We're good to get those back. First down and 10 for the Cougars. They got two receivers left. Here comes the snap. Ball goes over the left side. Nothing happening there. He's still grinding away. They need to go ahead and blow that dead. He's going nowhere. Maybe a gain of 2 yards, 1 or 2 yards on the play. Good work on the interior there by those big guys. You got Carson Davis in the middle there. Big Matt Burris, the man child, working hard. Jackson Smith and Grant McGinnis out on the ends there. Linebacker's doing a good job. Ryan the Hammer Hedge is always in on the action when it comes to tackling inside the tackles there. Cougars got two receivers to the right. Snap is back. He's looking right. Got a pass out. It's caught. And he's tackled out of bounds by Jackson Seward, along with a big shot from number 3, Aiden Auld. Good job getting him to the ground, but it was a nice gain. That's going to bring up third down and about 2 for the Cougars. Need to get off the field right here, Isaiah.
Yeah, no, that definitely boosts some spirits a little bit.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, we need to keep the momentum going and get the ball back. Would be nice to see our offense get a little rest right here, but we need to get the ball back from the Cougars. Cougars go one receiver right, one left, two in the backfield with the quarterback. Oh, come on now, guys. And we're going to get an offside penalty. It's the little things, Isaiah.
Yeah.
Watch the ball. Don't listen to the quarterback. Watch the ball. You learned that day one, football.
Yeah.
That's Pop Warner stuff, man. Watch the football. It's about discipline. And now you've given them a first down, and you're leaking away your momentum. Watch the ball. That was a huge play right there. First down and 10 for the Cougars. Ball at about the 25-yard line. Two receivers, one right, one left. Snap goes back. Ball's handed over left side. He's met in the backfield by Jackson, but he gets away. And Ryan the Hammer Hedge is there along with number 6, Braden Pickard, bringing him down on the tackle. Pickard was hanging on, and Hedge came and finished him off. That's another thing right there. Getting these guys in the backfield, you got to get them on the ground. If you meet them back there and get your hands on them, get them on the ground, or at least hold them up till your teammate can get there.
Right.
Because instead of a 2-yard loss, they get a 3-yard gain. It's a 5-yard swing in their favor, and you just got to make those tackles. Missed tackles is what gave up that long touchdown in the first period. Three guys had their hands on him. Cougars have it second down and seven. Four receivers, two wide right, two left. Passes away, and it falls incomplete. Defense was there by Aiden Ault to help knock that pass down. Is it me, or does it look like, I mean, am I being a Prague homer? Maybe I am, and that's okay. It's okay. I can do that now. I'm not in the press box. When you're in the press box, you can't say things that are negative. I'm not in the press box tonight. I'm here with you, so I can say what I need to say. But is it me, or does it look like their receivers, their slot receivers, are leaving early every time?
I was just now thinking that on that.
Every time.
Yep.
Nobody seems to care. And that, by the way, I just got a text from my lovely, way too good for me wife, and she said that was pick six, Braden Pickard, on that touchdown reception. Thank you for that, dear. We want to give him credit. That kid's a stud. Always want to give credit where credit's due. These kids work hard. And we want to make sure that they get their name called when they do something great. That was a great play. Appreciate my wife getting that to me. My wife loves to correct me. I noticed that. So if she has a chance to show me that something was wrong, I didn't know something, she loves to educate me and tell me when I do things wrong or don't know something. And so I appreciate her showing up right now and doing that. We have a timeout taken right here. It's third down and seven for the Cougars. Ball's at the 28-yard line. There's 3 minutes, 58 seconds remaining in the third period of play. And if you love high school football, this is it, isn't it?
This is it.
We're in September. The sun's gone down. It's nice and cool. The band's playing, the girls are dancing, the stands are full. Man, this place is packed out. I can't believe how many people showed up for this game, but it's absolutely packed out. And Prague showed up big as well, standing room only on the other side. And we got a great ball game to reward us tonight.
Oh, man, yeah.
20-20. Good. This is a way better game than last year. Last year, Prague beat them by 50 points.
That was hard to watch.
And it wasn't even a fun game anymore.
It was hard to watch.
I was glad to see that the Cougars have got a good squad this year. They're 2-0 coming into this game. They've been pitching shutouts, by the way. They haven't given up a point to this game.
Oh, really?
That's correct. All right, third down and seven. Three receivers wide. He fakes. He looks back. Oh, it's a screen pass. And McGinnis was right there. Grant McGinnis hanging on. I don't know. Is that legal to do that, to hang on to that guy like that coming out of the backfield?
I mean,
they didn't call it. It's right there in front of them. Heads up play by McGinnis, because that was about to turn into something great for them. A great play call by the Cougars there. A nice little screen pass on third down, and it didn't work out. McGinnis was there in coverage over that deal, taking care of that. Back deep to receive on fourth down on this punt is number six, Braden Pickard, and number three, Aiden Ault. Snap is back. Punt is away. It's not very good. It's a wobbler to the right. All thought about it for a second, didn't he? And then he decided better. And we're going to get the ball inside Cougar territory. 3 minutes, 44 seconds remaining in the third period of play. 20-20 is your score. Prague takes over first down and 10 at the 49 in Cougar territory. You can't really script it much better than that. Your offense got a little rest.
Yeah.
And they had to punt. We get to keep our momentum. And it was a terrible punt. We get it inside their territory. I would put Grant McGinnis back here, and I would feed him the ball. The Cougars look like they're on their heels a little bit.
Yeah, I agree.
When he's running the ball, and you mix it up a little bit between him and Ault running it, a good 1-2 punch.
Looks like they got Rex in there, huh?
Yep.
Yeah,
I got Rex. Geyser's back in, along with McGinnis. He's going to give the ball to McGinnis over the right side. Got a hold, and running hard over the right side. Nice gain of about 5 yards.
Do it again.
That's it, yep.
Do it again.
Now, my coach used to say this when I was in school. He'd say, 3 yards in a cloud of dust, boys. And I'd always say, Coach, that makes for fourth and one. 3 yards in a cloud of dust makes for fourth and one. See, when I was in school, a forward pass, that was called a trick play, Isaiah. They didn't really throw the ball much back in those days. And so, but 5 yards on first down is far better. You get out in front of it. Look like it's second down and five, second down and six here. I just would keep feeding McGinnis. And it looks like they're going to. He's going to go over the right side. Ball's on the ground. It looks like he lost it, and we'll see. And he hasn't made a signal yet. He's got his hand up. Did we recover it, Isaiah? I guess so, or he'd be calling,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
Yeah.
Prague ball.
All right, so that's going to bring up third down and long. Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Let me tell you what I don't like about that. Not that anybody cares, but McGinnis is a between the tackles runner. Not that he can't go around the corner, but he is most effective when you keep him inside.
Right, yeah.
Running north and south.
Yeah.
That's his game.
Yeah.
And now we've got that third down and seven. Looks like Martin's in it running back. Geiser drops back. He's got a receiver right there. It's caught.
Looks like a first down.
I think that's Braden Pickard yet again. It is Braden Pickard, and that's going to be right at the marker. And they're moving it. That's first down and 10 for the Red Devils. Geiser to Pickard. And that's that five-yard curl.
Yeah.
I take it all night. McGinnis in the middle for five and then throw it out on the edge for five. First down and 10, Geiser at quarterback. We got three receivers left, one right. Martin in the backfield with Geiser. Snap is back. Geiser's going to keep the ball himself, go up the middle, running hard, but met by a couple of Cougars. And maybe he gained a yard. And I don't know that we gained a yard there at all. It's going to be second down and 10. Oh, Geiser runs hard.
Yeah, but it's kind of hard when you get met by three of them right at the
yeah.
scrimmage.
Yeah. I know he lifted a lot of weights and ate a lot of food this summer, but three of them is kind of hard to drag around.
Yeah.
Second down and 10.
Just under 2 minutes here on the third.
Got two receivers wide, one right, one left. Martin in the backfield with Geiser. Geiser takes the snap, hands the ball to Martin right up the middle. And he's going to gain a few yards, but not very many.
Tackled by number 40, Blaine Robinson.
And that's going to bring up third down and probably, if I had to guess, looks like eight, seven. Third down and seven. Ball's at the 35-yard line of the Cougars. A minute 20 remaining in the period. In the third period, scores tied 20-20. Ronan Martin remains in the backfield. We have three receivers left, one right. Rex Geiser in at quarterback. Here's the snap. It's back. Geiser's looking for a receiver. Oh! Overshoots his target, which was Pickard. Falls incomplete. Going to bring up fourth down and seven. That was that same deal, that little five-yard curl. Mm-hmm. If we catch that, he's going to get that first down.
Right, yep.
It's just a little touch high. But since we're in Cougar territory, it looks like we're going to go for it anyway. I might run a little hitch and go right here. They're going to jump that if he does that again. Run a little hitch and go and send Fixico deep. Of course, I don't see Fixico on the field here. Maybe he's on the far side there.
Yeah, maybe.
Geiser gives him the hard count, snaps back. He's got a receiver to the right side, and it's caught, but I think it's going to be short. I'm going to go ahead and say it, Isaiah, because this is who I am. I say things that nobody wants me to say.
Let's hear it.
But I don't understand on fourth and seven why you run a six-yard curl.
No.
I mean, I understand that there's a timing element there, and you work on this all the time.
Right.
But it's fourth and seven. I'd go ahead and run a seven-yard curl right there.
You know, that would probably make sense. But.
And I know. Trying to work out all that timing, but it doesn't, doesn't do us any good if we come up a yard short there. I appreciate him making that grab. I think it was Fixico on the grab right there. But,
yeah, I like it.
But they do it in NFL all the time.
Oh, yeah.
They run short patterns that are short of the first down. I don't get it. So it's first down and 10 for the Cougars. They got three receivers wide. And the quarterback takes the snap, takes it over the left side himself. He's met down there. Looks like he was brought down by Ryan Hedge, number seven, big number seven. Oh, Hedge, he's been a stud.
Oh, man.
Golly. When he was a sophomore, he was a stud.
Oh, yeah.
And last year he just blossomed and became quite a player, and this year he's Ryan the Hammer Hedge. He'll bring it all the time. He's all the time in the mix, and when he comes, he comes angry and he's bringing a load. They got a good gain on that. Looks like second down and six for the Cougars, though. They got two receivers. Right? They come fast to the line. Quarterback takes the snap quickly. He's met by Fixico, and then he is chased down by number 58, Jackson Smith. As a flag comes in late, I think it's going to be something dumb, a dumb penalty. It had nothing to do with the play, I don't think.
No,
did it?
No, it didn't look like it at all.
We'll see. I wasn't paying attention. I was trying to get the number on who tackled there, and that was Jackson Smith. Fixico met him in the backfield first, but then Smith cleaned it up. I think it's going to be a personal foul probably. We tend to get some of those when we don't keep our composure.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just glad that I never lost my composure when I was in high school, Isaiah.
No, me neither.
Don't believe the stories you've heard about me. They're not true.
Me neither.
It's mythology. Yeah, penalty goes against Prague.
I didn't see no touching, grabbing or nothing. It must have been a mouth.
Something. They're going to mark it off, though.
Give him 15.
And that's going to give him a first down. Did he say holding? Is that what he said?
Oh, I don't think so. He only gave 5 yards, didn't he?
10.
10?
Gave him 10.
Yeah, okay, it might have been holding.
Maybe they were holding one of the receivers out here. That's kind of where the flag was at.
Right.
North Rock Creek comes out, two receivers left, one right, one in the backfield, one running back in the backfield with them. They're going to stop the clock again. Oh, that's going to bring us to the end of the third period. I was so focused in on what was happening there. So we got to the end of the third period. Scores tied 20-20. North Rock Creek and Prague are deadlocked. And North Rock Creek has got the ball, and they are on the move. With the assistance of the Red Devils.
Yeah.
We got to stop assisting them.
Yeah.
It doesn't seem like they need our help. And this has kind of been the thing with Prague so far this year that I noticed, is that Prague doesn't give up a lot of long drives. They give up big plays.
Right.
Or they have penalties that harm them,
mm-hmm.
and maybe assist the other team a little bit. And so we clean some of that up. Our defense is playing pretty solid, I think. So we keep that up, keep it going. We got to get the ball back right here and put some doubt in North Rock Creek's mind, though. While we're in this timeout, I'd like to take this opportunity to remind you of our game time sponsor, Garden Grove Baptist Church, right?
Yeah, and their preacher out there, he's I don't know about him, but.
They're not really the game time sponsor, but their preacher is a shameless plugger. He'll plug for his church all day. It's the little church of the big heart. All right, we're coming back to action here. First down and 10 for the Cougars. They got three receivers wide, two left, one right. Ball's at the 44-yard line. Snap is back. He fakes the handoff, throws the ball to Burdine. It's a little too high, falls incomplete. Jackson Seward was in the coverage there. It's a good thing that pass was a little high.
Mm.
He catches that. He's got some room to run out there.
And he's got a little height on Jackson.
Yeah, he does, and he's fast. He is a Burdine after all. Those Burdines are known to be fast. He is the son of Chadrick Burdine, who's a Prague graduate. I played football with Chad 100 years ago at Prague. Second down and 10. Snaps back. Ball goes up the middle to the running back. He breaks loose. Man, what a shoestring tackle there by Fixico. Man, if Joe doesn't tackle him by his shoestring right there, that's dangerous. That's going to break. That's going to break for a long run. Instead, good tackle by Joe Fixico brings up third down and about 3.
Yeah, that kid's quick.
Yeah, he's quick, and he's hard to bring down.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's stout. Yeah.
He's a good ball player for the Cougars. Cougars put together a nice squad. Got about 50 players on their squad. It looked much improved over last year. Third down and about 3. Watch for the hard count here, Red Devils. Watch the ball. Oh. Ball goes to the right side. Same running back. And he stood up there. Man, what a stout play right there.
Yeah.
Who led the charge on that?
I don't know. We're both blind up here, so.
Yeah, we got – and neither one of us can see.
Yeah, yeah.
Both blind and neither one of us can see. That's going to bring up fourth down. I don't know who led that charge, but somebody stood that up. And really
– I thought he advanced a little more than that, but – maybe not.
Great defense right there.
Awesome.
Prague needed that. Yeah. Back deep to receive is number 6, Braden Pickard. I'd like to see him get his hands on one and get loose. That kid is lightning in a bottle. Kicks away. High kick. A semi-spiral. Takes a great North Rock Creek bounce. Pickard thinks about it. Thinks again. Probably the best thing to do.
Yeah.
and they're going to touch it down at about the 11-yard line, 11 or 12. The Devils will set up shop right there. There's 10 minutes, 25 seconds remaining in the game. Score is tied 20-20. North Rock Creek has led most of the game. Prague had a chance to take the lead, got the extra point blocked, but maybe right here we can put together a drive and go put this thing away. It'd be great. Be interesting to see who they bring in at quarterback right here.
Yeah, I am curious. You know, think down here deep, you think they'd bring in Rex so he can get a little, throw the ball a little bit.
That's what I'm anticipating. It looks like it's going to be Auld, though. I see number three yeah. rolling out there. Auld brings that little wiggle out of the backfield. I anticipate they're going to try to run him a little bit. The kid is quick, and he swivels well. He's pretty slippery, too. He's kind of hard to bring down. Very gritty
kid. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Plays banged up, but plays hard. Tough-nosed kid. Snap is back. Auld fakes the handoff. Keeps it himself. Goes over the right side. Makes some guys miss. Running hard. Man.
That's fun to watch.
That is. Now he hit that. What button? Is that the B button that makes you spin?
That is the B.
The B button. He hit the B button there. Put him in the spin cycle. Made a couple of guys miss, and then took two or three to get him down.
First down play.
And that was good enough for a first down. I didn't realize he went that far.
Yeah, yeah.
First down. I told you, man, he's hard to bring down. He's, you know, he's not all that heavy, but, man, he's a gritty kid. First down and 10 for the Red Devils. McGinnis in the backfield with Auld. McGinnis will get the ball this time up the middle. Loses his footing a little bit. Falls forward for a short gain.
Tackled by number four, J.J. McClain.
And that's going to bring up second down and long for the Red Devils. Ball is at the 24-yard line.
Sale or half price. The baked goods, half price.
And so we'll see what the Devils dial up here on second down and 9. Yeah, I think McGinnis just kind of lost his footing there right off the start. Devils go 4 wide, 2 right, 2 left. McGinnis in the backfield with Auld. Spread them out a little bit, see what they do here. Here's a snap, it's back. Auld's looking for a receiver. Oh, no. Pass was intended for Shields. Auld was under duress there.
Yeah, that was a really good defensive play.
It was. We're lucky that was not intercepted.
Yeah, yeah.
That went right up in the air after it hit Shields. Looked like it hit him in the shoulder pads there and went up in the air, and it's very fortunate that it fell harmlessly to the ground. And that's going to bring up third down and 9 for the Red Devils. Ball at the 24, 25-yard line. They're going to go 3 wide to the left, 1 wide to the right. McGinnis in the backfield. And let's see what they dial up on third down. Snap is back. Auld rolls to his left. He's looking for a receiver. He's got Shields right there if he wants him. And he does.
Oh,
he puts it right on him.
That was a great throw.
Great throw on the run, going left. Yeah, and that's what you do, man. You take your left-handed quarterback, you roll him left.
Yeah.
Roll him left where he feels comfortable. And he makes a nice throw in there to Robbie Shields. He goes down, gets the ball, secures the catch, and moves the chains. That's all you got to do.
Yeah, I feel like he went right every time.
Well, he went left that time, and it worked out well. We got 3 receivers right on the right side this time, 1 on the left. McGinnis remains in the backfield with Auld. Snap is back. Auld keeps the ball over the left side. Got a little crease there. Nice hard running. Nice hard running. Looks like he picked up about 9 yards on first down. Listen, you get big positive yardage like that on first down. That makes your play calling so much easier.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
It takes a lot of pressure off your offensive coordinator. There's 8 minutes and 13 seconds remaining in the game. It's second down and 2 for the Red Devils. They are approaching midfield. They're at the 44. Game is tied 20-20. 3 receivers right, 1 left. McGinnis in the backfield with Auld. Snap is back. Auld's going to keep it again over the left side, waiting patiently. Gets around the corner and is dragged out of bounds there after he crossed midfield, and that's good enough for another Red Devil first down. You got to give Auld some credit there. He runs hard. And he's right back up on his feet, coming right back to the huddle. He's a tough kid. I know he was one of the kids that was sick this week, wasn't feeling well.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yeah. And I only know that because I'm related to him.
Yeah.
I get the inside scoop from his family. We got 3 receivers right, 1 left. Ald takes the snap, hands the ball to McGinnis. Loses his footing again. He was just about to put that foot in the ground and go north and south.
Yeah.
And I think if he does, he's going to get about 5 or 6 yards just because he's got momentum. But he lost his footing again, slipped down, only gained about a yard. Bring up second down and 9. Ball's at the 44-yard line of the Cougars. 7:27 remaining in the game. 3 receivers right, 1 left. McGinnis remains in the backfield with Ald. Snap is back. Ball goes to McGinnis up the middle. There he goes. He's getting south now. Attaboy. Way to run hard there. Grant the grinder McGinnis right up the gut. What did I tell you a while ago? Run that boy up the middle.
Give it to him.
McGinnis's were their workhorses, man.
Oh yeah.
Up the middle.
Yeah.
He don't
need to be bouncing out.
No. And he can at times he can get around the edge.
Right.
But he does his best work north and south.
Right.
And he didn't have to make a cut. He just kind of got right in the middle and went straight ahead. And them old boys get tired of tackling him about this time of the ball game. 3 receivers right again, 1 left. McGinnis remains in the backfield. Ald takes the ball over the left side. Got a little running room over there. Goes out of stiff arm. Goes around the corner and runs safely out of bounds after a nice, nice gain on first down. Ald and McGinnis have got the attention of North Rock Creek because their student section is getting loud, their band's getting loud, they're trying to, and the cheerleaders are cheering. They're trying to slow down this momentum, but this is a train moving forward. We need to keep the momentum going. Second down and 4. Ball's at the 28-yard line, 3 right, 1 left. Ald takes the snap, hands it to McGinnis up the middle. Oh, man, he's running hard. That a kid.
Yeah.
Way to run hard. It looked like he wasn't going to get anything there. And he's going to limp off a little bit. They kind of came down on the back of his legs, kind of awkward. Did you see that?
Yeah.
Tough kid, though. Gets up and trots off. Those McGinnises, they're built different. I mean, they're just built different. I mean, you just see them walk in the room, and you can tell that they're a McGinnis.
Yeah.
I mean, they're just built different.
I got them big old block heads on them, too.
I'll let you tell them that. 3 right, 1 left. Ald takes the ball right up the gut, 3rd down and 1, and he's got plenty for the first down. And that'll give the Red Devils another first down and 10 at the 20-yard line of the Cougars. 5 minutes, 57 seconds remaining in this tied ball game, 2020. Isaiah?
Yes, sir.
The Devils have burned nearly 5 minutes
on
this drive.
Yeah, that's why I was just sitting here thinking. This is.
It was 10-something when they started this drive, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, are those timeout totals correct down there?
I believe they are, yeah.
So Cougars only got 1 timeout left.
Yep, and the Devils have 2. First down and 10 at the 20-yard line. Ald takes the snap, hands it to Ronan Martin up the middle. Got a little running room, gets chopped down there. Looks like he gained about 4 yards, which would bring up 2nd down and 6. And the clock is just ticking. And you know that the Cougars are watching that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And they got their eyes on that. And boy, if the Devils could go ahead and just burn off another 2 or 3 minutes, just grind this thing out.
Yeah. Keep giving.
That'd be great.
Keep giving it to them.
3 receivers right, 1 left. Ronan Martin in the background, in backfield, pardon me, with Aiden Ald. Snaps back. And Martin gets the carry again, driving his legs hard over that right side. He's going to be taken down at about the 13-yard line. That's going to be close, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a little short, but
they're indicating 3rd down. Oh, yeah, he's way short. I mean, I couldn't tell from here where the sticks were at. But
2 yards or so.
Yeah, 3rd down and 2. Ball's at the about the 13-yard line of the Cougars. 4.5 minutes remaining in the game. 3 receivers right again. Ronan Martin in the backfield. 1 receiver left. Ald takes the snap. Heads around the left side. He's got a little bit of room. Nice block out on the outside. Get a move right there.
Man.
Oh, man. That's going to be good enough for a first down, though. Who is that receiver out there on the left side? Who is that? Let's give that kid some credit. Is that Fixico out there? I mean, just taking that corner and just driving him. Ready. Took him out to the parking lot, put him in the car, and buckled the seatbelt for him. I was like, take that kid to the house. Yeah, that's Fixico. Fixico, he's so gritty, too.
He's just
a mean football player. I love it. 3 receivers right. Fixico to the left again. Martin remains in it Or is that McGinnis back in there? That's Martin. All takes the ball to the left side. Got a little bit of room. Goes around the corner and into the end zone. We'll walk in for a Red Devil touchdown.
Aiden Auld.
You know what? He deserved it.
Oh, yeah.
Now I want to back up for a second here. Let's give credit where credit is due. Auld ran his guts out on that series, and so did McGinnis, and so did Martin. But let's give some credit to that offensive line. Those blockers.
Right, yeah.
Receivers blocking out on the edge. Offensive line blocking hard down in the middle. You got some studs down there. You got old Trevor Worley, one of the most undersized linemen out there, and just works so hard.
Uh-huh.
Kick is up, and it is good. And that's good news. That gives us a 7-point lead. Prague is leading 27-20 over North Rock Creek with 4 minutes, 9 seconds remaining in the ball game. And now there's some doubt creeping into the minds of the Cougars. That's what we want. We want that doubt in there. We don't want them to believe. We want them to be thinking about that 50-point loss that they suffered last year at Prague. And dash their hopes right here. Let's go ahead and get a good defensive stand right here and put them away. Go 3-0 into our district play. Man, how about that drive though?
Oh yeah,
burned 6 minutes. Did they get the ball at about the 12-yard line?
It was 12. I think it was 11 actually. Yeah.
Yeah. Yep. So I mean, a nearly 90-yard drive takes about 6 minutes. Well called.
Oh yes.
Well called. Yep. And well-executed drive by the Red Devils.
Once McGinnis found his footing, he really.
Yeah. He's a difference maker, yeah. That's for sure. Oh, and all of man is running his guts out on that series.
Yeah.
That's a senior taking his team, putting them on his shoulders and saying, I've got this.
Yeah.
Schultz is back.
One and a half shoulders.
Yeah, 1.5 shoulders. Kick is away. Caught about the 10-yard line. Takes the ball around the left side. He makes a couple of guys miss. Oh, he's still on his feet. Finally tackled down about the 30. That guy is so dangerous, man. So dangerous. Robbie Shields has proven to be such a commodity for us. Last week he was putting them in the end zone. And that is just so beneficial to a football team. If you got a high school kicker and put one in the end zone and reduce the number of runbacks. That was one of two touchdowns that North Rock Creek scored last year.
Mm-hmm.
They only scored twice, and one of them was a kickoff return from that guy right there. First down and 10 for the Cougars at the 30-yard line. They come out four wide, three left, one to the right, empty backfield. There comes a snap. I swear those guys are moving early. There comes a pass, and it's knocked down. I thought Auld had a chance to intercept
it. I thought he had it for a second. Good play either way.
Yeah, it looked like a pretty good pass, but Auld was there in the defense, and we escape one there. Second down and 10 for the Cougars. Ball's at the 30-yard line. 3 minutes, 54 seconds remaining in the game. Prague leading 27-20 over the North Rock Creek Cougars. Play comes in. Huddle is broken. Three receivers left. Two right, two left. That one kid was coming off the field. Snaps back. Ball's handed up the middle. He's met by a couple of Red Devils. That was kind of a messy exchange there, wasn't it?
Yeah, they've been struggling with that a couple times.
And he looks like he gained about 3 yards. Brings up third down and 7, maybe 8 yards for the Cougars. 3:33 remaining in the game. Cougars break the huddle. Two right, two left. Pardon me, the empty backfield. Three left, two to the right. Receivers all alone. Here comes a nice pass. Oh! Pass was intended for number one. Burdine went right through his hands. He's upset with himself. That was a give me first down.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And so we appreciate that. That's going to bring up fourth down and 8 for the Cougars. All he's got to do is make that catch. That's first down for the Cougars right there. I wouldn't be surprised to see them come right back to that right here. The Red Devils are giving them a lot of cushion. So we'll see what happens right here. Fourth down and 8. Timeout is going to be taken by the Cougars. Timeout taken with 3 minutes, 18 seconds remaining in the game. Prague leading 27-20 over North Rock Creek. It's fourth down and 8 at the 32-yard line for the Cougars when they come back. What are you looking for, Isaiah? It's fourth and 8. What are you dialing up if you're the Cougars?
Definitely not one of your curl routes that are a little short.
I'm not going to dial up a 7-yard curl route. It drives me crazy. I'm a recovering Dallas Cowboys fan, and I've watched them do this several times. I've been going to rehab for being a Dallas Cowboys
fan.
About
20 years now.
Yeah, it's taken me several years to get over it. I've watched them do the same thing. Even on the professional level, it doesn't make any sense to me why you would run short of the sticks and turn around. But Burdine had a first down right there if he catches that ball. And maybe more than that. He's got some wiggle.
That's what I was thinking. He really didn't have anyone around him.
And the thing is, I know the Red Devils want to give him some cushion. You sure don't want to get burned deep, that's for sure.
Nope.
Not in this situation. Keep everything in front of you. Come up, make a tackle, and let this clock run out, I guess. Fourth down and 8 for the Cougars. They are out 5 wide. Quarterback is alone in the backfield. Snap is back. Quarterback is back looking for receiver. He's hit by Matt Burris. Ball's in the air. Pick it off. Pick it off, Joe. Take it. Joe Fixico has got the ball going up the left side, and he will score. Touchdown, Red Devils. Joe Fixico. How about that? How about that?
I think I got too busy watching that, and I don't know if the camera picked it all up. But
well, in case you missed it, Big Matt Burris broke through the line, introduced himself to the quarterback, and now he refers, the quarterback now refers to him as Mr. Burris. Mr. Waterburger Burris. And the ball was thrown as he was getting hit, and it kind of floated on him a little bit and gave Fixico, who's got great closing speed, gave him plenty of time to make a play and take it up the sideline for a Red Devil touchdown. Now we got Robbie Schiltz, little swivel hips, is up for the extra point. Snap is back, ball's down, kick is away, and it is good. And that will move us to 34-20. Your Red Devils leading with 3 minutes and 7 seconds remaining in the fourth period of play. Man, what a play.
Oh, yeah.
Fourth and 8. And, great play by my Fixico. I mean, to see that ball go after it and then to finish that at the end zone and leave no doubt. But that was made possible by the pressure put on the quarterback.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
When you got Manchild Burris coming at you, it tends to affect you. I know if he was running at me, every now and then, Isaiah, I start watching and I think I could still do this, even though I'm almost 45 years old. And then I see them get hit by a guy like Matt Burris, and I think I would never get up.
Yeah.
I'd break into 1,000 pieces. And so I'll just stay up here with you until next week, and then I'll go back to the booth and do what I do, and you guys will carry on. And
are you back in the booth for the next game?
Well, we're on the road again next week.
Are we?
Yep. We got one more week on the road, then we'll be back home, and I'll be back in the booth. You'll get Brooks back from wherever he's at, and you guys will be at it again here live streaming.
He's playing Cowboy this week.
Oh, he's playing Cowboy.
Yeah.
All right, Schiltz is on the kick, going north to south. It's a small, short kick. It's taken, I could have swore he called a fair catch. I'd go ahead and light him up anyway. Well, these guys are all saying, well, he waved his hand, but then he waved his hand and he caught the ball and he took off running.
Right.
I'd go ahead and light his rear up. You don't wave your hand for a fair catch and then take off running and then get mad if someone tackles you. Just go ahead and light him up and let the referee sort it out. Either way, no flags, no problems. He caught it. He caught a fair catch and then tried to advance the ball, which you cannot do. I'm not a rules expert, but I'm pretty sure you can't do that.
No, I don't think so.
And that's going to give the Cougars first down and 10 at the 35-yard line. Let's see here. A little confusion from the Cougars. The quarterback's wanting everybody on the line.
She's usually what he wants.
Yeah, he wants him up there blocking. He's going to go up block number 52. That kid. Uh-oh, here comes number 55. We need another lineman. There we go. Another lineman would help. I wouldn't make it any easier. Snaps back, ball's away. Pass is dropped again. And I think it was intended for Burdine again. I think he was trying to make a move before he caught the ball.
Right.
And And that's typical. Receivers want to do that. You got to secure that catch first. And he can make a move. The kid's quick. But the ball falls harmlessly to the turf. It's second down and 10. 2 minutes, 56 seconds remaining in the game. Red Devils leading by 14. Four receivers wide. Snap is back. Ball goes up the middle. Old Ryan the Hammer Hedge is right there to stick his face in there. Ronan Martin in on the tackle as well. Look like Big Matt Burris in there again as well. Matty Ice. I got a million names for old Matt. Matty Ice, Whataburger Burris. I think Whataburger Burris would be the one that sticks.
I like that one.
That kid eats there every day.
Oh, yeah. I mean, this multiple times I've been driving through Shawnee and see the Burris is walking in Whataburger.
I was looking for him one day. I just drove to Whataburger. I assume he's there.
Yeah.
Third down and six, passes away and hits the receiver in the chest, and he drops it again. This is a different receiver. This time we had Jayon Friend in the coverage there. Let me tell you what's happening right here, Isaiah. I'm not a football expert, but letting that ball travel all the way to your pads, you're supposed to get those hands out there and catch it out here and make that diamond shape. And when it travels all the way to your pads, it has a tendency to bounce off your pads.
Right.
And the last two passes were dropped because they came all the way into the pads. Get those hands out there and catch that ball. But that's good for us, fourth down and six.
Yeah, we are not complaining.
Nope. Keep dropping them. Snap is back. Quarterback's looking for a receiver. He's got one across the middle.
Man.
Same play that he scored on before. The running back had caught it, and he's going to go score a touchdown. Isaiah. That is the same play they scored on in the first half.
Is it?
Yeah. And I've been waiting on them to come back to it. Mm. What they're doing is they're getting their running back into a one-on-one situation with our linebacker, and it's a mismatch.
Right.
Every time. Credit to North Rock Creek for seeing that and making that play call. But Ryan Hedge is a hammer, but he is no one-on-one coverage man when it comes to a running back. You see this happen on the collegiate level, NFL level all the time as well. People want to get their running backs on linebackers. And it's effective, and that's what happened right there. And it just was an easy touchdown for him right there. Cougars go for two here. Man in motion right to left. Snap is back. It's on the ground. He dropped it. It's picked up. And pass falls incomplete.
Got a flag down over
and
there.
Got a flag down. I think it's going to be pass interference, don't you think?
Yeah, I agree.
He was kind of all over the receiver
there.
Yeah,
a little bit.
Nope, it was a false start.
Oh.
Well, I was wondering if they were going to call that because they've been doing it all night.
No.
But is that just me? If anybody else is watching this on the TV, you can see that they've been moving early all night, the receivers have. Penalties decline. Score remains 34-26. Prague is leading by 8 points with 2 minutes and 12 seconds to go in this game. So this game's not over. We kind of hoped it was over. Was that fourth down that they scored on a while ago? That was fourth down, wasn't it?
It was. It sure enough was. Yeah.
Man, I tell you what. And that's not Ryan Hedge's fault.
No.
I mean, Ryan Hedge is just you're asking a big linebacker.
Yeah.
Who could easily play on our offensive line, right? I mean, he's a big guy.
Yeah.
You're asking him to cover a running back that's very elusive and very good one-on-one in the open field, and it's just that's a tall order for anybody. Good play call by the Cougars. But Prague has a chance to ice this thing. I anticipate we'll see a lot of Grant the Grinder McGinnis here in just a moment, don't you think? Trying to get this clock run down. The Cougars have no timeouts remaining. Prague has two. We'll get to see an onside kick attempt first, it looks like. We got our hands team up here. Up in the middle, we got number 22. That's Jake Atkinson. That's my boy right there. I like that kid. Got Carson Davis. We got Mason Provoznik and others right here. Going to look for the onside kick, and here it comes. Comes to Provoznik, and he gets it. Mason Provoznik, number 9. Takes the ball into his chest and falls to the ground at the 50-yard line. Good job, Mason. Mason's an exciting young player, too.
Yes.
He's a junior. He's not playing a lot this year.
Mm-hmm.
But the kid has been in the weight room. He's looking good, and I promise you next year he's going to be an impact player for us. We're going to need him. And he did a great job right there. That is a nerve-wracking job.
Oh, man.
Knowing the ball is going to come at you 30 miles an hour.
Right in the forehead.
Yep. And you got to secure that thing for your team in order to help seal this win, hopefully. And he did a masterful job of that. Credit to Provoznik. I went to school with his dad, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I played basketball with his dad, Travis Provosny.
You know, with no timeouts left for him, you think one first down and kind of wrap it up.
Yes, sir. We got guys are in there with McGinnis, two big guys. And there goes McGinnis right up the middle, grinding out about 4 yards on that. Bring up second down and 6 or 7 for the Red Devils. Let the clock run. We're going to go under 2 minutes right here. 1:58 remaining in the game.
Looks like he might have gained a little more than we thought.
Second down and what do you think, 7 yards?
Yeah.
And there's nothing the Cougars can do about it. 14 seconds on the play clock, 1:41 on the game clock. McGinnis and Rex the Rifleman Geyser in the backfield. Two receivers. And McGinnis is going to get the ball again. And nowhere to go. Looks like he might have lost a yard. And that's going to bring up third down and about 8.
This is a big one right here.
A long 8. Maybe 9. Yeah. This is a big play. You know, and I don't know if that's not maybe a place where you leave old Auld in there with McGinnis and make him wander. If you're going to run it up the gut or have him keep it around the outside, have Auld keep it around the outside.
Yeah, I agree.
And here comes Auld right now, as a fact. Yeah. In a matter of fact, Auld is back there with McGinnis. We got a timeout. Play clock got away from us. Timeout was taken by the Red Devils. 46 seconds remaining in the game. Prague leading 34-26. And they got it third down and 7. All did check in, and I'm not surprised by that because they need to have some options for us. Got a little action going on out here in the parking lot. Got the EMTs out here. Hopefully everybody's okay back there. Anyway, we're praying that everybody back there is okay and doing well. No major issues. Looks like they're talking to somebody. I don't see any police force, just medical emergency officials. All right, we're coming back to action right here. We got Aiden Auld checked in at quarterback. Three receivers left, one right. McGinnis in the backfield with Auld. Third down and 7. There's the snap. Auld's going to take it around the left side. I kind of anticipated this might happen. He goes around the left side. Nowhere to run to, and he's swallowed up there. Probably lost another yard.
They didn't start the clock there.
And now the clock is moving. Yeah, they sure didn't, did they?
Nope.
And now we've got another timeout, looks like. Well, this is pretty simple. Even though you've had the one bad snap over your punter's head, you snap the ball back here to Braden. You let Braden kick it down here, and you make the Cougars go 80, 85, 90 yards in 38 seconds with no timeouts.
Yeah.
And even if they do, even if they get lucky and they throw another pass like they just did, hopefully we got a safety to help cover that up, then they still got to go for 2 and get that to tie the game.
Right.
Just to put it into overtime. So I think your punt is the way to go here. Calm your long snapper down and say, just put it back there on him and just get a punt away and kill a little bit of time here. The Cougars won't have a whole lot of time. They'll use about probably 6 or 7 seconds just on the punt alone. Seems to be a lot of discussion going on. What's the discussion about here, Isaiah?
I don't know. Oh, yeah, it is the game clock.
They're going to move it back up to 42 seconds after they didn't start the clock? Or 32 seconds. There you go, 32 seconds.
That's better.
I thought that guy was signaling 42.
Yeah, me too.
I was like, we're not going to give you more time when you didn't even start the clock to begin with. Honey, I know we're nice guys and all. Now they're going to have another discussion. North Rock Creek will get there 42 seconds probably is what's going to happen. Another mound conference here. You got to give some credit to the Cougars, though. They could have laid down after that pick six.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Could have laid down and said, well, this game's over. We'll go into district play 2-1.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and they've played well. Like I said, they hadn't given up any points until tonight. Tonight's the first time they've given up points. They gave up 34 tonight, though. They shut out Little Axe, and they shut out somebody else. I can't remember who it was. I looked at it earlier today. Now the clock is rolling. There we go. We're down to 30 seconds and ticking. And the play clock is at 36 seconds. So I think that's going to wrap it up for us. The Devils are going to wait this out. Joe Fixico is waving his hands, an encouragement to our crowd to cheer him on. And this clock is going to wind down, and the Red Devils are going to come away 3-0 in non-district play. 34-26 is going to be your final. The Red Devils are victorious over the North Rock Creek Cougars. Great ball game tonight.
Yeah.
Great ball game by both sides. Great play calling. Good hard play. And it's good to come out with the win right there.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, they grounded that one.
We're on the road again next week. Where are we going next week?
It's bye week next week. And then the following week is on the road. I should probably know this, but.
You are the Squirtle guy. You're supposed to know these things.
Yeah, I'll figure it out when it that
yeah.
week.
These, yeah. You guys can look it up, and we got bye week next week, and then we look forward to being on the road again to play and start our district play. We invite you to come out and cheer on the Red Devils. We thank you for listening to Red Devil football tonight on the Squirtle, and this is your final. Prague 34, North Rock Creek 26. Thank you for listening, and God bless you.